Hello, my name is Evan from Renogy's User Experience Department, and today I will show you how to solve some problems that you may encounter with your battery and controller. If the controller is showing a E01 message, that means that there is a problem. There are four reasons that may cause an E1 error. They are: the battery power is low, the battery has broken down, the controller's over-discharge voltage warning is false, or the controller has broken down. These four problems may cause the E01 warning to appear. In order to solve the E01 warning message, we'll first test the wires, then the battery, and then the controller. The first step when trying to solve any problem with your solar system is to first check the wires and cables don't have any problems. To do this, we need to use a multimeter and set it to the ohms setting. From there, take the nodes and measure across the wires as such. If the multimeter displays zero, then the wires are in correct order. Once we've checked that the wires themselves have no problems, we then want to make sure that the wires are inserted correctly. To do this, take the multimeter again and switch it to the DC voltage setting. Then take the nodes and measure across the wires as such. If a multimeter shows a positive number, then the wires are inserted correctly. The tools needed to inspect the battery are a multimeter and the instruction manual. Next, turn to the charging specifications section in the instruction manual. Use a multimeter to measure the voltage across the battery. For non-lithium batteries, use the same method by first measuring the voltage across the battery. We've just used a multimeter and the instruction manual to measure the voltage across the battery. Next, we'll take that data and analyze the battery. If the measurement on the multimeter is lower than the low voltage disconnect number in the instruction manual, then it will show an E01 warning message. For non-lithium ion batteries, the battery will break down if the voltage is less than 6 volts. Lithium ion batteries will automatically turn off if the voltage drops below 10 volts. If the battery is within the warranty period, please contact the retailer to organise a replacement. If there's no excessive voltage and the battery's power is low, we can solve the problem using the following method. First, turn off all appliances connected to the battery. Next, please check the wiring and make sure all wires and cables are connected correctly. Next, if the power transmission icon on the controller screen is flashing and showing an MPPT message, that means the battery is not at fault. If the controller is showing the E1 warning message and the battery's power button is not lit, it is most likely because the power is too low. This means that the battery needs to be activated. To do this, press and hold the right-hand button and select the lithium ion battery setting. Press the right-hand button again and save it as a preference. The battery will then start to automatically charge. Now that the battery has been checked, we'll next check the controller. Use a multimeter set to the DC voltage setting. find the charging table in the controller's manual. After measuring the voltage across the battery, measure the voltage across the battery port on the controller and make sure that the two measurements are the same. Also take a note of this new measurement. Next, measure the battery and also measure the battery port on the controller and note the measurement on the multimeter to make sure that they are the same. To check whether the over-discharge measurement is correct, switch to the user setting by long pressing on the right-hand button and then short press again, and scroll down until you get to the last setting, which shows the over-discharge voltage. If it is correct, long press the right-hand button and it will take you back to the main page. Next, we will use the measurements taken to analyze the controller. If the measurements taken from the battery and controller are different, please note that a 0.2 deviation is normal. If there is a difference greater than 0.2, then the E01 warning message will show. If a controller does not show the same voltage reading as in the manual, then there is a fault in the controller's measuring. We've tested the controller and found the problem. Now we will try and solve the problem step by step. If a controller does not show the same voltage reading as in the manual, then there is a fault in the controller's measuring. Once the controller has been found to have a problem, please contact Renogy for further assistance at the address below. In order to solve the E01 warning, we have tested the cables, battery, and finally the controller. We hope that this step-by-step instructional video has helped you to solve your problem.